We first introduced you to the Farmer's Fridge in 2019 when the Chicago-based startup brought its concept to Indianapolis. The company's smart fridges are similar to vending machines, but stocked with healthy, fresh-made meals and stationed in busy office towers. But less than a year after launching in Indy, offices emptied as the pandemic sent workers home. Business of Health reporter Kylie Valletta tells us how the company is now adjusting its recipe for success. Kylie?
Thank you very much, Gary. Farmer's Fridge took a huge hit during the first 2 weeks of the pandemic when business plummeted 80% because the smart fridges rely on busy office buildings. Within 2 days, the company shifted its focus to a new option, home delivery. The concept has gained traction over the last 12 months, and now Hoosiers in almost any area of the state can have a healthy meal delivered to their doorstep. Farmer's Fridge founder and chief executive officer Luke Saunders joins me now to tell us how the company's footprint will soon cover the entire state. Hi, Luke. Thanks for being on the show today.
Yeah, thank you so much for having me.
All right, well, give us a quick refresher of Farmer's Fridge and how your mission really centers on healthy, fresh food.
Yeah, so the whole idea behind Farmer's Fridge is how do you make fresh, healthy food as accessible as a candy bar? So just before I started the business, I was a traveling salesperson driving 1,000 miles a week, and the whole idea was just get fresh, healthy food to more places. And when we started, that was actually through the smart fridges or vending machines that we put in offices, universities, and even places like the Indianapolis airport.
And I know the airport has three of them still operating now. So let's talk about the pandemic. You have this perfect business model all set up, and then it's completely turned on its head. There's like tumbleweeds blowing through offices and downtown. So take us back to what that time was like and how Farmer's Fridge responded.
Yeah, I mean, we were sitting in our own office thinking, okay, we may have to close soon. And we know a lot of our customers are busy people at work. They're on the go. They're traveling through the airport. That's about to stop. So where are they going to go? And we realized a lot of them were going to go home. And so they wouldn't be buying food at the fridges. And we thought, can we leverage what we do, which is make fresh, healthy food in a centralized kitchen? We have our own trucks and vans that distribute that food locally. Can we just change what we do to deliver it to people's houses? Because they're going to be just as busy. They're just going to be stuck at home. In a lot of ways, they're going to need things because there's not good food options for them at home. It's a whole new routine. So over the weekend, we built a Shopify website. We got the ops team behind switching our drivers from the nighttime to the daytime. We started doing home deliveries and actually were able to get back to our pre-pandemic revenue within about 6 to 8 weeks of the original shelter in place.
Wow, that's incredible. Okay, Luke, you just glazed over it, but you said over the weekend you made this happen. Tell me, just emphasize the timeline that you guys did this in.
Yeah, so I mean, we had always thought about how we would do home delivery. The focus was fridges, but when you're trying to make fresh, healthy food as accessible as a candy bar, really you want to be able to get it to wherever people are, and we knew we couldn't put a fridge everywhere. So nothing's more convenient than shipping it right to someone's front door. We had sort of piloted a few things, and then over the weekend, we had the tech team working late into the night to build a website that we could actually let customers come and take an order. And we had to do some things on the ops team to make it all possible. But really, it happened over the course of a weekend because we said, you know, if we don't do this, we have no idea how long this is going to last. And our revenue is going to go down 80% because really we only were serving hospitals at that point. And so we had to figure out something. It was more of one of those moments where you say, like, if this doesn't work, I don't know what else we're going to do. And everybody just banded together and figured it out.
All right. Pretty impressive 48-hour pivot. So right now you deliver about roughly the top two-thirds, northern two-thirds of the state of Indiana. Tell us how you could expand to the whole state very soon.
Yeah. So right now we're actually, we do own delivery, which is our vans. Then they drive around certain parts of the state. And then we partnered with UPS and FedEx to ship to about two-thirds, like you mentioned. So if you're, you know, within 30 miles south of Indianapolis up, we cover you in that delivery zone. And right now we're working on expanding it to the rest of the state over the next few months.
So we've talked about home delivery, but Farmer's Fridge, obviously fridge is in your name. It's who you are. How are the fridges doing now? And what's the plan for the fridges going forward?
Yeah, I mean, overall, the fridges that are open are doing great. So, for example, in Indianapolis, we opened with about 30 fridges. We actually added 4 during the pandemic, and about half of them are operating right now. And the fridges that are open are actually doing better than before the pandemic. We added features like touchless pickup, where you don't have to touch the fridge at all. And there's a lot less options. And so people are just where the fridges are, they're doing very well. And now as people are going back to the office, so even here, we're starting to see people trickle in. Things are continuing to improve. But it's actually still our biggest business, and still at the heart of what we do, because like you said, it's in our name, and it's a very unique offering that we do in the fridge.
Okay, just a few seconds left, Luke, but I want to give you a chance to talk about the meals that you've donated and also a new chef collaboration that also is going to benefit some people.
Yeah, so one of the things that we did in addition to launching home delivery is we really leaned into feeding frontline workers and communities in need. So we actually raised over $1 million and donated over 500,000 meals to communities in need and frontline workers at the height of the pandemic. And we continue to have hospitals be one of the biggest part of our business. And then we launched a chef collaboration program. So the same thing, we looked at the restaurant industry and said, how can we support this industry? And we were able to partner with some world-class chefs. And the current program that's running is actually Rick Bayless, a master chef. And is, you can order a Rick Bayless meal delivered right to your front door.
All right, Luke, congratulations on your recent pivot, and keep us posted on how it goes.
Thank you so much for having me.
All right, Gary, back to you.